Look at these two X-rays. Both of these patients presented to the emergency room with gradually increasing dyspnea since 3 weeks. In both these patients, you can see that one side of the thorax is opaque and another side of the thorax is well aerated. Both these patients have different diagnosis, which can be made by looking at the X-ray. Can you come to the diagnosis? Pause this video for a few seconds and form your opinion. If you can't come to a definite and different diagnosis for these two patients, then this video is for you. Welcome to Radio Clinics. In this video, I'll be discussing on approach to unilateral whiteout lung. The most important causes for unilateral whiteout lung are massive pleural effusion, unilateral total lung collapse, large thoracic mass, and massive unilateral consolidation. There are other infrequent causes also, like after removal of a lung, but these four are the commonly seen causes of whiteout lungs, and you should be able to differentiate them from an X-ray. Coming to the first cause, which is massive pleural effusion. Massive pleural effusion is characterized by mass effect, which means it causes deviation of trachea and mediastinum towards the opposite side. There will be no any air bronchograms in massive pleural effusion because air bronchograms are features of consolidation. This is the normal lung, and in the second image we can see that there is effusion in the right side. This effusion has caused mass effect with passive collapse of the right lung. It is causing deviation of the trachea towards the left side, and mediastinum is also deviated towards the left side. The next cause for opaque hemithorax is unilateral lung collapse. Unilateral lung collapse is characterized by features of volume loss. There are no air bronchograms in unilateral lung collapse because air bronchograms are features of consolidation. Features of volume loss like trachea and mediastinum being pulled towards the same side are seen in case of lung collapse. There may be abrupt cutoff of the bronchus. Take this third image for an example. In this image, we can see that there is endobronchial foreign body in the right main bronchus. This endobronchial foreign body has caused obstruction of the right main bronchus and the right lung is collapsed. There is feature of volume loss of the right lung, so there is elevation of the right-sided hemidiaphragm, hyperinflation of the left lung, and deviation of trachea and mediastinum towards the right side. The other cause for unilateral opaque hemithorax is large thoracic mass. Masses are more or less rounded in shape and have heterogeneous appearance. Heterogeneous appearance means the masses have varying density in different regions of the mass. Usually the masses are more denser towards the center and less denser towards the periphery. Trachea and mediastinum are neither pulled nor pushed by the lesion. However, the large mass may cause pushing of the trachea and mediastinum towards the opposite side, and when mass is associated with collapse of the lung, the trachea and mediastinum may be pulled towards the same side. There will be no any air bronchograms in the mass because the bronchi will be blocked by the mass. Other features pointing to malignancy like bone erosion, lymph nodes, and ancillary features may also be seen in case of mass. Now coming to consolidation. Consolidation are characterized by air bronchograms. In consolidation, exudate fill the alveoli while the bronchi are patent. So these appear as air bronchograms in the chest X-ray. The mediastinum and trachea are central in location because there is no mass effect from the consolidation. Now coming to our query, in the first image we can appreciate the following things. Left hemithorax is opaque or whiteout. Trachea is deviated towards the left side. Mediastinum is shifted towards the left side. Always remember that one third of the heart should lie to the right of the midline. But in this case, there is no any part of the heart lying to the right of the midline. Abrupt cutoff of the left main bronchus is also seen. So with these features of volume loss, we can say that this is a case of left lung collapse. The next step we can do in this patient is either to do a bronchoscopy or a CT scan to find the cause of collapse. In the second image, we can appreciate the following things. Right hemithorax is white out. The trachea is slightly deviated towards the left side because of the mass effect from the opacity. There is no any air bronchograms in the opacity. So with these features of mass effect, we can say that this is a case of massive right-sided pleural effusion. The next step we can do in this patient is to do a pleural tapping, which can be both diagnostic and therapeutic. Coming to the final words for the presentation, in case of an opaque hemithorax, you should look for features of volume loss or mass effect to come to the diagnosis. So you should pay attention to the trachea, mediastinum, and also look if there is presence of air bronchograms. If there are features of volume loss, which is indicated by shift of the trachea and mediastinum towards the same side, this indicates lung collapse. If there are features of mass effect, which is characterized by trachea and mediastinum pushed away from the side of the opacity, then this is due to effusion. If the trachea and mediastinum are central in location, you should think of either consolidation or mass. Lung masses are usually rounded in shape, while consolidations are characterized by air bronchograms. Thank you.